So children, for today's class, we'll discuss direct proportions. What is meant by direct proportion? If you take one quantity as x, the other quantity as y, if you increase x, y also increases. If you decrease x, y also decreases. That is called direct proportion. That is called direct proportion. Okay, one example I told you now, children. If you put 1 liter, you will go 10 kilometers. If you put 2 liters, you will go 20 kilometers. If you put 3 liters, you will go 30 kilometers. Means this is increasing, means this is also increasing. If you put, no sir, 1 liter, no, I won't put 1/2 liter only, I'll put, means you will go 5 kilometers only. Because when you decrease this, this also decreases. This simultaneous increase or decrease in proportionally, such type of proportion is called direct proportion. If you increase one, the other also increases. If you work for 2 days, you will get 200 rupees. If you work for 3 days, you will get 300 rupees. If you work for 10 days, you will get 1,000 rupees. More the days, more is the salary. Like that. Okay. So how much work you do, that much proportionally amount also salary also you are getting. So that type of proportionality is called direct proportion. If this is increasing, this is also increasing. If this is decreasing, this will also decrease. Such type of proportion is called what, children? Direct proportion. Okay, in this direct proportion, what happens means, in this direct proportion, you see, children, I told x is directly proportional to y. X is directly proportional to y. Then if I remove proportionality, I can write x is equal to ky. What is k? Some constant. K is some constant. If I put y down, x by y is equal to k, means always this constant will be equal. If this is coming 1/2, means every time it will come 1/2 only. If this is coming 2/3, every time it will come 2/3 only. If this is coming 5/7, means every time it will come 5/7 only. So for two quantities, this can I can write as x1 by y1 is equal to x2 by y2. No sir, I want one more, means yes, you can write. No sir, I want one more, means yes, you can write. How many quantities you want, that many quantities you can write. All are in proportion, because they all are, if this is 1/2, this also will be 1/2, this also will be 1/2, this also 1/2. Means, I'll show you. I told you now, children, if you put 10 liters, imagine you are going 50 kilometers. Okay, children, if you are going, if you are putting 10 liters, if you are putting 20 liters, imagine you are going 100 kilometers. If you are putting 30 liters, imagine you are going 150 kilometers. Now check the proportion. What is 10/50? 1/5. What is 20/100? 1/5. What is 30/150? 1/5. Every time I am getting same constant, that is called direct proportion. Everywhere fraction is 1/5. First time also 1/5. Second time also 1/5. Third time also 1/5. Fourth term also 1/5. Fifth time also will be 1/5. 100th time also 1/5. That's why I'm saying x by y is k, constant. Constant means how many times you take the same answer you will get. That is called constant. I hope you are able to understand. Please copy this, 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 and this, children. All of you, mute your audios. Mute your audios first. Please copy this, children. 1, 2, 3, 4. Please copy first. If you copy, then I will say, explain some numericals, children. When I explain some numericals, you will clearly understand what is a direct proportion. You will clearly understand. There will not be having any problem. First, say x is directly proportional to y. Removing proportionality, keep a constant k. Where k is called constant. Where k, removing proportionality, keep a constant k. Where k is called constant. What is constant? X by y is constant. If you increase it for four cases, if you increase this for four cases, x by y1, x2 by y2, x3 by y3, x4 by y4, 100 times also increase, proportion k is always same. Here, how much I took? 1/5. Even 1,000th time also, it will come 1/5 only. Proportion won't change. That is called direct proportion. Okay, then we'll do some numericals. If I do some numericals, then you will understand very, very clearly. Some numericals I'm telling you, children, please listen. Try to follow, children. Small numericals I will tell, then I will go to big numericals. First one. I hope everyone are able to see, children. A car travels 432 kilometers in 48 liters of petrol. 432 kilometers it is traveling with 48 liters of petrol. Then for 20 liters of petrol, how much distance it will travel? How much distance it will travel? This is the question. Okay, children. Okay, for 48 liters, it is going 432 kilometers. For 20 liters, how much distance? They are in proportion, actually. They are in proportion. I already told. They are in proportion. Okay. What is in proportion, children? This and this are in proportion. This and this are in proportion. For 48 liters, if 432 kilometers means, for 20 liters, it will be less, no, children? It will be less, no? So let's check really whether it's coming less or not. Please see here, children, all of you. So take like this. 432 by x is equal to 48 by 20. 432 by x is equal to 48 by 20. You have to concentrate, children. If you don't concentrate, you won't understand. Cross multiplication. 432 into 20 is equal to 48 into x. 48 you bring down, children. X is equal to 432 into 20 by 48. Okay, children. So what happens? 4. Okay. So 2 tens are 224, sir. 2 fives are 212, sir. See, 12 threes are 36. 12 sixes are 72. So x is equal to how much you are getting? 36 into 5 is 35. 180. Children, 180 kilometers it will go. How much distance it will go? 180 kilometers. With 20 liters, okay? With 20 liters, I'm writing statement here, children, which you have right at the top. With 20 liters, it will travel. How much? 180 kilometers. Hope you are able to understand. First lesson, children, okay? And simultaneously copy also, okay? Second one, those who need to understand, at least try to understand this one, children. 40 meters of cloth. 40 meters of cloth is 1940 rupees. Try to understand, children. 40 meters of cloth is 1940 rupees. Then for how much meters of cloth, how many meters of cloth you can bring it for 727.5 rupees. For 1940 rupees, if you are getting 40 meters, for 725.5 rupees, how many meters you'll get? Children, this is increasing means this will decrease means this will also decrease. So you have to say they are in direct proportion, okay? Because you have to say they are in direct proportion. So 40 by x is equal to 1940 by 727.5. Cross multiplication, 40 into 727.5 is equal to, please copy, children, along with me, 1940 into x. Okay, 1940 will come down. Those who say, no sir, we can't copy and we can't understand, listen. Then later I will send video, at that time you listen again and copy. It's up to you, children. So 40 into 727.5 by 1940. Children, here after point, how many numbers are there? 1. So put 10, children. Okay. After point, one number is there. No, so put 10. Okay. I am removing the point. Here 0 cancel. Here is 0 cancel. Please check here. 4 4s are 16, 4 8s are 32, 4 5s are. Okay, so x is equal to 7275 by 485. If you simplify, children, you will get 15. Okay, 15 meters of cloth you can purchase with 727.5 rupees. With that much rupees, he can how much meters of cloth he can buy, children? 15 meters of the cloth he can buy. 15 meters of the cloth he can buy. Okay. One more sum, children. Here we are going to discuss one more sum. Please listen. One more sum, children, for your understanding. For 200 kilometers, a taxi will charge you 260 rupees. So, for how many kilometers it will charge you 279.50 rupees? Same, children. For 200 kilometers, 260 means this is increasing, means the distance also increases. Simple logic. So it is in direct proportion. You should say it is in direct proportion. 200 by x is equal to 260 by 279.50. Go for cross multiplication. 200 into 279.50 is equal to x into 260. Bring 260 down, children. 200 into 279.50 by 260. If you solve this, children, this is 13. Okay, so if you solve this entire thing, children, you'll get 215 kilometers. For 215 kilometers, that fellows will charge 279.5 rupees. Okay, children, for 200 kilometers, 260. So for 215 kilometers, 279.50 rupees. This by this is equal to this by this. Simple logic, children. Nothing is there. Very, very easy. In fact, direct proportion is the most favorite topic for 8th class students because it's very easy. Okay. Next one. One more sum, those who did not understand. Very easy sum, I'm saying, children. Reema can type 540 words in half an hour. Half an hour means how much, children? 30 minutes. In 30 minutes, Reema can type how many words, children? 540 words. Then how many words she can type in 6 minutes? In 6 minutes, she can type less or more, children. Can anyone say?
Lesser.
Less. Okay, if time is decreased, words also will decrease. So definitely it is a direct proportion. Okay, in 30 minutes, 540 minutes, in 6 minutes, it will be less or more, children. Simple logic. So same, 540 by x is equal to 30 by 6. Okay, cross multiplication, children, 540 into 6 is equal to x into 30. Bring 30 down, x is equal to 540 into 6 by 30. 3 twos are 108 words. In 6 minutes, she can type only 108 words. That's all, children. She can't type more than that. Time is decreased, means words also will decrease. No, children. Simple logic. There's no rocket science involved in that. Fifth question. Very easy, children. Children, there is a weighing machine. If you put 150 grams on weighing machine, extension will be 2.9 centimeters. Okay? Then, for how much grams it will extend to 17.4 centimeters? This is the question. You're able to understand, children? You're able to understand? For 150 grams extension in the spring weighing machine, when you are going outside, you'll be your parents, they will be weighing your luggage, you know, all those things like that. Okay, for 150 grams, 2.9 centimeters is the extension. For how much grams, this will be the extensions. So if this is increased, this also will increase. Simple logic. So direct proportion, that is in direct proportion, you should write it is direct proportion. 150 by x is equal to 2.9 by 17.4. 150 by x is equal to, please listen, children, after point one number is there, after point one number is there, remove the decimal. Okay, children, so cross multiplication, 150 into 174 is equal to x into 29. Bring 29 down, children. X is equal to 150 into 174 by 29. Okay, and that will become 900. For 900 grams, the extension is so much. How much, children? For 900 grams, if you put it, the extension will be this much, 17.4 centimeters. Okay, children? Are you able to understand? Are you able to understand, children? One box sum, children. One box sum. Like this, they will give boxes and they will say direct proportion you have to do, children. It's very easy. Box sum. They will say this is x, this is y. This is 5, this is 8. This is x, this is 12. This is 10, this is some a, you think. This is b. And this is 35, this is c. Find a, b, c. And they will say they are in direct proportion. How to do like this sum, children? Very easy, children. How to do? They are direct proportion. So 5 by 8 is equal to a by 12. Simple. You will get a. 12 you bring here. A is equal to 5 into 12 by 8. Okay. 60 by 8. 60 by 8 is 30 by 4. 15 by 2. How much, children? 7.5. So a is 7.5. Now how to find out b? Same. This you can do or this also you can do. 5 by 8 is equal to 10 by b you can do, children. 5 by 8 is equal to 10 by b you can do. You will get b also. And 5 by 8 is equal to 35 by c also you can do. All are in direct proportions, children. All are in direct proportions. You do cross multiplication, you'll get a, b, c. That's it, children. You'll get a, b, c. No, sir, I want to do, don't want to do like this. I will do using this both also. It's also you can do, children. 5.5 by 12 is equal to 10 by b. Like that also you can do. Because in proportionality, all are constant. I told you so many times. Okay, children, please copy, children, and basing on this, some examples, everything I will give, children, you have to do it as homework. Okay, children, you have to do it as homework. Now, all of you log in again, children, we will do science. Please copy down, and in the worksheet I put, in the video link, description will be there, in that worksheet, homework will be there. In the video link, description, worksheet will be there, children. You have to do that homework for max. Log in again, all of you.